I'm Kiara Eldred, and we are in the Johnston Lab in Mud Hall of Johns Hopkins University. I look at stochastic gene expression, and I use the human eye as a way to look at that. I actually grow human retinas in a dish, so I use stem cells, and I aggregate them, and then I make little baby retinas in a dish that I can study. This is the retinal cup forming here. I'm looking for more structures that have this kind of organized layer on them. So let's see if I can show you, like this part here. That's good. This is really good. That one's beautiful. Short term, we're going to be looking at how a cell chooses its fate. So we're looking at the photoreceptors and how they choose to either be red, green, or blue. We use stochastic cell fate in many different parts of our body. It's in our eyes, in our olfactory systems that we can smell, and in our motor neurons. If we gain insight into the simple system where there's only three choices, maybe we can make broader connections to systems that have many more choices, like motor neurons. Everyone in my family is very art-oriented, but I was always very curious when I was younger about like biological questions, why something works a certain way. In middle school, I joined what they called GEMS program, Girls in Engineering, Math, and Sciences, and we did a lot of little experiments once a month. So when I first started being curious about biological systems, I of course wanted to be a doctor. When I started doing research, because that's a way to gain experience and start moving in the direction of being a doctor, I realized that I really loved answering basic questions and working in a lab and running a gel and finding an answer. And that just got me really excited about science. I think that collaboration is really the key for developing something that is gonna be important and used. If it's a really a tough construct, sometimes I'll do 7, 10. Everyone in this lab works on Drosophila, and then I work on human things. The collaboration between those two projects is pretty interesting and only happens really in lab meeting space. So this project specifically is a really tough one. I force aggregate my retinas and then they have to grow for 200 to 300 days before I can do any kind of experiments on them. And no one had ever done that here in the lab. So one of the best moments for me scientifically was when I'd been growing these retinas here for the first time for 200 days. And I imaged them on the microscope. I think it was 1 a.m. And I saw expression of everything that I hoped would be there. And I had been working towards it for so long, I actually cried. I was so happy.
As you would.
Because I knew then that my project was going to work. I am so excited that I am probing mechanisms in the human system. Like, we're finding answers to what is regulating gene expression in our eyes. I don't think there's much cooler than that, to know that you're actually figuring out how we see color. You know, like what are the mechanisms behind that? And that's what we're trying to figure out every day. Pick a lab that's doing something you're really excited about, that's really interesting to you. And a lot of people say you should like try a bunch of new things, but I think it's really important to stick with something for at least a year and really understand the problem and really get into the nitty-gritty day-to-day of what that science is, because that's when you're going to make exciting discoveries, is when you really put some time and work into it, because you're not going to find something new usually on your second day. You know, it takes some time to think about the problem, to really get into it, but yeah, choose something that's really, really interesting to you.